So here we are in my feral garden. This plant here is Elaeagnus umbellata, or autumn olive, and it's in full flower right now. It's just beautiful when it's in flower. And so here it is in full flower. And I suspect this one is going to be covered with the delicious red fruit or berries this year. Technically it's a fruit, but they look like berries. And you eat them by the handful, you can eat the seeds and all. The fruit contains 17 times the lycopene as a tomato, and that's the substance that they're using in cancer research to help prevent and fight cancer. The seed also contains a good amount of protein and fat and is actually very tasty. And there's all sorts of vitamins and minerals and nutrients inside the berries and the seeds, and they make great dried fruit as well. I just love the way they smell, and the bees seem to love them. Just a few days ago, these plants were covered with bees feeding on their nectar. And the plants are beautiful, and often are planted for ornamental purposes, and they're extremely tough and drought tolerant and soil tolerant, and can take lots of wind and all kinds of conditions. And they plant them for their beauty because all the leaves, buds, flowers, stems, and even the fruit has these gold and silver speckles on it, these gold and silver dots, and it's characteristic of the Elaeagnus genus. So if you look, this one's in full flower, and behind me there are actually several more plants too that I've planted. And you can see there's one here, and there's a beautiful one there covered with flowers, and there's one over there. And then there's one there that's actually already done flowering for the year. And if you look a little bit over there, you'll see another one next to the Baccharis. And then there's actually another one over here by the fence under the black walnut. So it's pretty clear, I think, that I like these plants. I planted a lot of things though in this garden, and just sort of see what would make it and what would survive, and these have not only survived but they've thrived, and a lot of other things haven't. So it looks like this is all I planted, but I basically planted an Elaeagnus in every guild. In permaculture, a guild is a community of plants that mutually benefit each other just like they do in a natural ecosystem. And so the function of the Elaeagnus, besides being beautiful and attracting bees, producing an amazingly nutritious and delicious fruit, but is that they fix nitrogen in the soil, and they sort of grow faster than other plants, and so they can provide shelter, windbreak, and it's also short-lived, and so it potentially dies and then gets shaded out by the canopy tree that you plant next to it. So it helps protect your canopy tree when it's small from wind. Helps protect it from overexposure and sun, helps preserve the soil. These lose a lot of leaves in the winter and they break down really fast in the soil. So it sort of just like fertilizes the system and gets it going. And I tell you, it also provides an incredible amount of beauty, extremely fragrant and amazing flowers. And all it feeds bees, like I was saying, it fixes nitrogen in the soil, and it makes this amazing fruit, which sort of has the form of a berry, but technically it's a fruit. And the seed inside is edible too. And that's actually the main reason I grow these.